Telecommunication Engineering, class number 2. So today we'll discuss about circuit switch and packet switch network. So let me discuss about circuit switch network first. It is basically a connection oriented switching technique. There should be a dedicated path between calling subscriber and called subscriber. So it is basically a connection oriented network. There should be some phases of circuit switch network. First, you have to build up some circuit. Basically, there should be some dedicated path between between called and calling subscriber. So this call basically will pass through some dedicated not dedicated actually some intermediate points. Okay. So once we have some dedicated path between calling and call subscriber, the data exchange will happen, not only data, voice as well. So there should be some data transfer mechanism between calling and call subscriber, and then after this entire communication will get over, we'll have a circuit discontinuation. And this discontinuation process can be initiated from calling and call subscriber, any of the calling and call subscriber. That means both of this calling and call subscriber have the liberty to discontinue any call. This is the basic structure of circuit switch network. Let's consider subscriber. Say this is subscriber A. Wants to call subscriber B sitting here. So these are the intermediate points, say 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. Now let's consider some path is getting established in this way. So from A to 1 2 5 8 and B. So path will look like this: A to intermediate node 1, then 2, then 5, and then 8, and then from then to called subscriber B. So this is basically depends on some network condition. Okay, the availability of intermediate node. Fine. So this is now is going to be the dedicated path for communication. Now once this path setup is completed, then there should be some data exchange mechanism. Okay, after the communication get over, there should be some discontinuation. So this is basically the circuit switch network. This is basically the circuit switch network. So there should be some so this is basically a wired network. Fine. Now let me discuss about the merits and demerits of circuit switch network. So first of all, we have some dedicated path between source and destination, which is ensuring the steady state data rate. Fine. Secondly, path remains dedicated throughout the entire duration of communication. And thirdly, except the path setup delay. So basically the delaying agent in case of circuit switch network is the initial path setup delay, and there are nothing except that, because intermediate nodes are having no delay at all. So basically it's a very fast communication, and as we are having some dedicated path, so this is basically very secure kind of communication, very high quality of communication with ensured data rate. Fine. Now what about demerits? It is basically the data rate is basically very low, because allocating dedicated path may harm the overall throughput of the systems. Means what? Means we are having some dedicated path. Basically, let's consider we are having this dedicated path to communicate between A and B, this is dedicated. So this all this node basically now for the entire duration of communication is dedicated to calling subscriber A and called subscriber B. So this node can never be used for other types of communication here occupied simultaneously. So this actually the overall network throughput get harmed. Okay. Secondly, even if your data rate is low, bandwidth requirement is always high. Why bandwidth requirement is high? Because we are having some broadband path between source and destination, dedicated path. So always bandwidth requirement is very high for that. And as I mentioned earlier, its advantage is also a disadvantage of this type of network, because path setup time is very high. So this is a definite problem. Secondly, too many numbers of subscriber accommodation in this network is very difficult, because if there is so many simultaneous communication happens throughout this network, this type of network is not capable enough to accommodate this type of communication simultaneously. So accommodating a huge number of subscriber for this type of network is difficult again. So this is all about circuit switch network. So let me discuss about packet switch network now. So basically, in case of a packet switch network, unlike circuit switch network, which was actually wired network, that means connection oriented network, packet switch network is not necessarily connection oriented network. That means it can be wireless as well. Okay. And in case of packet switch network, packet, that is data packet, is the main concept here. Data and voice transmitted in the form of a basic unit called a packet. So data transport in data transferred in packet form. Okay. So packet switching technique is basically formation of packet. So enter deliverable of the parties involved in communication is distributed into some basic unit called a packet. All the packet contains some header, payload and trailer. So basically we have each and every packet having some basic format. This format is we have some header, we have some payload and we have some trailer. So basically this header contains the destination address. So we have some source, we have some destination. So this header is having some destination address. Payload is basically the data field, it contains the data, and trailer is basically the address of next packet. That means once you are transferring some packets, so that means you are dividing your entire data into some packets. So there should be some sequences. Now your all the packets are transferring from source to destination. Let's see here. This is your say this is your source. This is your destination. These are computers. This is your source. This is your destination. So you have several packets. You have numbers of packets to transmit from this to that. So what happens? So these packets are very much sequential, because these are the encoded data. So if you change any sequence, this may create some kind of anomaly. So this is absolutely necessary to retain the address of immediate next packet. Fine. Now routing the routing of packets. Packets are transmitted via intermediate nodes. These all are intermediate nodes, can be switch, and not necessarily via the same path. This is very important point. That means all the packets are transmits from source to destination, But not necessarily all the packet will follow the same transmission path. Immediate next thing is rearrangement of the packet. Now once all the packet transmitted to this destination, now it is the responsibility of this destination basically to rearrange the packets and decode the actual messages. So let's consider we have this is your source computer, say computer A, this is your destination computer B. Okay, we have some data like this. Say A is a data packet, we have another data packet say B, and we have another data packet say C. All these three data packets is constituting a message. Now this data packet transmits separately, say this data packet A followed this way, this path, that means from say this is node 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now say A is following the path, A data packet following the path say on to node 2, then node 6, then computer B. Okay, data packet B following some other path, say B is following in that way, say B here following in that path, say from 1 to 3 to 5, then 6, then B. Okay, so data packet C is following further different path, that means in that way, so C will go in that way, and that means from 1 to 4, then 5, then 6, then B. That means path can be anywhere, path can be anywhere, and this data packet follow any path. So ultimately what we are receiving here is basically data packet A, data packet B, data packet B and data packet C. Not necessarily in order, order can be reversed, but basically this trailer field having some address, which is the next data packet of which data packets. So based on that, it will again will get arranged like A, B and C. So it is basically, this rearrangement is basically the responsibility of receiving network. Fine. So let me discuss the merits and demerits of this type of network again. So as like the earlier case, that means circuit switch network, there is no dedicated path. That means if any network, that means if any intermediate switch get failed, routing can be done via different intermediate network, because routing is path different, no dedicated path is over here. Fine. Again, it allows simultaneous usage of same channel by multiple user, because for each and every user there is no intermediate dedicated nodes. Because this user A sitting over here is using these nodes, this node A, but this is just passing for passing a data packets only. That means a very short duration of interval it is occupying this intermediate node. So after that, any of the other sender sitting over here can transmit a signal via this node. So that will not a problem. So this is also possible. So overall throughput of the system get enhanced by that. Okay, Again, it ensures better bandwidth utilization and hence larger throughput. Better bandwidth utilization means because this none of the node is getting permanently occupied by any sender or receiver. Because of that, overall throughput of the system will be very high. Okay, if you discuss about demerits, you know, loss of packets may create communication anomaly. Here the data packet A, B and C combinedly constitute some message. If some data packet, say data packet B, get lost, so ultimately it will be very difficult to retrieve the original message for that receiver unless and until we are having this data packet B again. So that may create communication anomaly. So again, delay, because we are sending numbers of data packet through our through different path, so there may be some associated delay. So that may create a that may not be affordable for this kind of communications. Again, this protocol is very complex in nature and installation is very costly again. And then most importantly, we are using some address field here and some trailer field. This is also address field. So basically we are utilizing, that means we are wasting some bandwidth to transmit this address field. And this is necessary because the decoding at the receiving end is necessary because this is for rearranging purposes. So again, to transmit this address field throughout this communication channel, this is also the wastage of bandwidth. So this may harm the bandwidth utilization of the entire system. So again, that should be taken care of. So these are the merits and demerits of this packet switch networks. So we'll discuss digital switching technique later on. Thank you.